amateur baseball is one of Minnesota's great sporting traditions. The state tournament brings together hundreds of communities in late summer at great ballparks all around the state. Coverage of every game can be found on PrepSpotlight.tv. PrepSpotlight.tv's coverage of today's state tournament game is made possible by the Minnesota Baseball Association. And also with help from the Minnesota Twins. Celebrate town ball with the Twins on September 11th. Visit twinsbaseball.com/townball for details. Now let's get to the ballpark.
Welcome back. Game two here on Prep Spotlight TV. Game two of four on the day. Town Ball Class A State Tournament. Game one in the books. St. Anthony Hogs won 5-1 over the Bloomington Bandits. Game two here. Minneapolis Mudcats against the Highland Park Beavers. Mitch Widmar helping you bring the coverage here on Prep Spotlight TV. Winner of this one will take on the Hogs of St. Anthony next Saturday. First pitch slated for 4 p.m. The winner will get to a quarterfinal, Highland Park against the Minneapolis Mudcats. Mudcats, the home team. Black uniforms, white pants, sort of like a turquoise-looking color lettering on the front and the back. Highland Park Beavers in their blue uniforms with the white pants and the blue stripe down the side. 1, 2, 3 in the order. It'll be Corey Ryder, Simon Hayek, and Max Sellum. 1, 2, 3 in the order. They'll be facing Logan McDonald. McDonald, first pitch of the game. We are underway. It's a ball low to Corey Ryder. McDonald on the bump. Tyler Fliss catching balls and strikes. David Diamond at third. James Wolfel at short. Max Gerstner at second. Milo Holmes at first. This one chopped foul. Left to right in the outfield for the Mudcats. Caden Christensen in left. Lucas Fleming in center. Avery Nelson is in right field for the Minneapolis Mudcats. One ball, one strike to Corey Ryder. Leadoff hitter plays first base for the Beavers. This one punched to short. Wolfel. Strong arm across the way, 6-3 for out number one. One up, one down here in the top of the first inning. Just underway, Mudcats Beavers. Center fielder. Those old school Red Sox.
Center fielder now.
The blue Simon and red stripes, Hayek. Simon Hayek. Batting with one out here in the first. First pitch, wave and a miss. Logan McDonald gets ahead in the count. No balls, one strike. And some great games so far here yesterday and today at Palm Field here in St. Anthony. 0-1 off the wrist to second. Gerstner over to first, 4-3. Two up, two down here in the top of the first inning. That'll bring up Max Sellum. Batting third, playing short for the Beavers. Logan McDonald wheeling and dealing here early on for the Mudcats. Two ground outs to get this one going. First pitch from McDonald, touches up the outside corner, strike one. Picture-perfect day, just like yesterday. Right back here at Palm Field, the great state of Minnesota. 0-1 misses off the plate from McDonald. It was 75 degrees at first pitch in game one this morning at 10 a.m. We had a 12:58 first pitch here in game two. 82 degrees at first pitch. This is Max Sellum knocks a two-out single into left field. One on, two out for the Beavers. Brings up Alex Sellum. So Alex Sellum, second baseman, will bat here. With Max on first base and two out in the top of the first inning. Got two more games after this one later on this afternoon and then tonight. Fastball below the knees, ball one. Corey Ryder grounded out to short. Simon Hyatt grounded out to second. Max Salim, a two-out single on first base. 1-0 count. You betcha. Off speed pitch, peppers the zone, and it's 1-1.
We sit there?
Oh, yeah, come on.
One ball, one strike, McDonald from the stretch. Pop foul out of play. One ball, two strikes to Alex Salim. Matt Nelson waiting on deck. Beavers and the Mudcats. Here in a first round matchup, single elimination. Tom Ball, Class A state tournament here on Prep Spotlight TV. Down low, and it's 3-2. Max Salim will be on the move. Full count, two outs. Anything in the gap could score him. 3-2 from McDonald, runner off. Lofted into shallow left field. Moving over to his right, cap high catch, the shortstop, James Wolfel. And that will retire the side here in the top of the first. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left on base. Bottom first we go. Mudcats, Minneapolis will have their first crack at it coming up next here.
Reminder
on Prep Spotlight
TV.
Nobody does high school sports like PrepSpotlight.tv. Your home for Minnesota State tournament action is also where you can find the best weekly action during the regular season in 2021. We make it easy to be a high school sports fan at PrepSpotlight.tv. Celebrate the end of the 2021 town ball season. Join your teammates, rivals, and ball fans from around the state at the Twins game on September 11th. Special ticket pricing for town ball players and fans, salutes to the newly crowned champs, and a very fun night at the ballpark. Order your tickets at twinsbaseball.com/townball and wear your town's team colors to Target Field on September 11th.
Bottom of the first inning, you're getting a look there at Mitch Maurer, southpaw. Toe in the rubber in this first round afternoon matchup for the Highland Park Beavers. 1-2-3, James Wolfel, Avery Nelson, Milo Holmes will bat this inning for the Mudcats. 0-0 our score, bottom one here on Prep Spotlight TV. Maurer finishing up his warm-up tosses. He's throwing balls and strikes to his catcher, Zach Straighten. Andy Devine at third. Max Salim at short, Alex Salim at second, so the Salim duo working up the middle at short and second base. Corey Ryder at first, Jake Fleming in left, Simon Hayek in center, and Matt Nelson in right field for the Beavers. James Wolf, a leadoff hitter, shortstop. Bats first here, bottom one for the Mudcats. Lefty looks in and delivers and misses for ball one. Ball, no strikes to James Wolfel. That one cuts the plate. One ball, one strike. Emphatic strike call from the home plate umpire. 1-1. Wave and miss, strike two. One ball, two strikes. Now we're working very quickly out there on the rubber for the Beavers. 1-2 inside. Wolfel had a slide out of the way, back foot, 2-2. Avery Nelson, a lefty, waits on deck. Fastball's got some late life on it for Maurer. Off the plate on that one, though, for ball three. Now three balls and two strikes. This one popped foul back out of play. Do it again at three balls and two strikes to Wolfel. The 3-2, wave and a miss, strike three. Wolfel goes down swinging for out number one. One up, one down, it'll bring up Avery Nelson, the right fielder for the Mudcats. Lefty on lefty
right
matchup.
Right fielder now, number 22, Avery Nelson.
First pitch from Maurer right down the boulevard for strike one. Breeze is blowing in at the moment from left to right. It's a strong breeze, too, that has picked up. Game one, it blew out. Then started blowing in towards the end of the game, but it wasn't anything crazy either way, and it's definitely picked up here for game two. The 0-2 misses upstairs and away, and it's one ball, two strikes to Avery Nelson. One out here, bottom of the first. Off-speed pitch, good eye from Nelson. Maurer couldn't get him to fetch. Evens up the count at 2-2 to number 22. This one lofted in shallow center field. That'll drop in for a one-out single for Avery Nelson. One-on-one out for the Mudcats. Bring up Milo Holmes.
First baseman number 19, Milo Holmes.
See what kind of lead Nelson gets over there at first. You see him far right of your screen. Decent lead for a lefty that's on the mound. Swing and a miss from Milo Holmes. First baseman batting third in the lineup for the Mudcats here this afternoon. Maurer now working from the stretch with the runner on base. The 0-1 popped up, back out of play. 0-2. Wolfel struck out swinging. Avery Nelson on first. One out single here. Bottom one. High and tight. Two balls, two strikes. Man, Maurer's fastball definitely has some zest to it early on in this contest. He'll try to locate his spot here. The 2-2 fouled off the screen. We'll do it again. Two balls, two strikes. That one downstairs, good eye. See if Nelson's on the move here. Just one out, but a 3-2 count. Good speed over there at first base. Not running, 3-2, into center field. Charging in is Simon Hayek, and it'll land in. Hayek scoops it on the one hop in center field, back-to-back singles for the Mudcats. Brings up Lucas Fleming, the center fielder. Two on, one out, bottom one.
Center fielder number 23, Lucas Fleming.
Check swing, went around, strike one. Fleming the cleanup hitter in this affair for the Mudcats. Golden opportunity early on with two on and just one out, bottom of the first. Didn't go around that time. High chatter, misses for a ball. Maurer trying to wiggle out of a little log jam here. Two on, one out. The 1-2 just missed inside. Throws up Fleming. Showed a good eye though, and it's 2-2. Wave and a miss. Strike three. Fleming goes down swinging. Two outs for Matt Gerstner. Batting fifth Lefty-on-lefty matchup
second
again.
Second baseman now, number 10, Max Gerstner.
So Gerstner will bat. Second baseman down in the number 10. Hitting with a runner in scoring position here in the first. This one through the hole on the left side. They're going to wave around Avery Nelson. The throw coming in from Fleming. Now they're going to hold the runners. So everyone stays put. One base to another. That's the third single of the inning for Minneapolis. Bases loaded, two outs for Caden Christensen. Both lefties, Avery Nelson and Matt Gerstner, have gotten a single this inning for the Mudcats. Bases loaded, two outs. Wave and a miss, strike one. Wolfel struck out swinging. Nelson and Holmes singled. They're on third base and second base, respectively. Lucas Fleming struck out swinging, and now Gerstner on first after a single. One misses down low, perhaps a bit in, and it's 1-1. Now we're trying to work out of an early jam here. Nowhere to put Christensen. Fastball away, and it's 2-1. Two balls and one strike. Pitch to Caden Christensen is looped foul out to the right. 2-2. Three singles so far this inning for the Mudcats, trying to capitalize here with two outs in the first. That one right down Main Street. Christensen knew it. Three hits, but also three strikeouts in the inning for Maurer. So no runs, three hits, no errors, three left on base. We will head to the top of the second inning. 0-0 Highland Park Beavers, Minneapolis Mudcats here on Prep Spotlight TV.
All summer long, you have gathered with friends, neighbors, and family at ball yards all across Minnesota.
Still going, gone, a home run!
Diamonds that decorate and help define hundreds of communities. Town Ball binds together our passion for baseball in our hometowns. And on September 11th, the cornerstone of Minnesota baseball, Target Field, will host a party for all those who play, watch, and support Town Ball. The Twins host the Royals at 6:10 p.m. Prior to the game, the newly crowned state amateur champs will be honored at the Town Ball Tavern and during a pregame ceremony. Wear your team colors and enjoy a special night at Target Field.
The 0-2 pitch. Strike three! Fairmont! State champions in 2020!
For tickets to the Twins' tip of the cap to Town Ball on September 11th, visit twinsbaseball.com/townball.
Zero, zero, top two here from Palm Field. Logan McDonald back out there, 5-6-7 in the order. Matt Nelson, Andy Devine, Pat Sheehy do this inning. Good cut there from Matt Nelson. 0-1. Logan McDonald working from the wind. The pitch, check swing, goes down low. Peel down to first, no swing, 1-1. A 1-1, skips in the dirt, 2-1. side, and it's 3-1. Three balls and two strikes to Matt Nelson. McDonald from the line, the pitch. Leadoff walk. Field out at first, they say Nelson did not go, and he's on base to start the top of the second inning.
Third baseman now, Andy Devine.
Devine bats here with one on and nobody out. First pitch, strike one. Fastball upstairs, one ball, one strike. Donald working from the stretch here with Matt Nelson on first. He's being held on the bag by Holmes. Nelson getting a pretty aggressive lead over there at first base. McDonald delivers. Big wave and a miss, 1-2. Nobody out here, top of the second inning. Andy Devine batting sixth, playing third base for the Highland Park Beavers. Trying to keep things moving offensively here. 1-2. Wave and a miss, strike three. First punch out for Logan McDonald here in this one. One out now, top two.
Designated hitter now, number 12, Pat Sheehy.
Pat Sheehy will bat, designated hitter. Seventh in the lineup card. One on, one out, top two. Off speed pitch, just misses. Umpire might have flinched a bit there, but it's a ball, 1-0. Nelson fakes the steal. It's grounded over to the right side. Holmes went there initially. They call him out at first. It looked like Holmes picked his foot up off the base, but the umpire said he got it back down in time. Kind of a chaotic play as Holmes initially made a beeline towards the ball in the hole, but then Gerstner had to come all the way back over to his left. End of the day, Matt Nelson gets to second, but they get the 4-3 put out at first base for out number two.
Catcher down number six, Zach Straighten.
Two outs, runner on second, top two for Zach Straighten, the catcher. Good lead at second for Nelson. Had a great lead at first. Secondary lead is huge, too. He's about halfway down the base path there in between second and third on that secondary lead. Nelson led off the inning with a walk. Andy Devine struck out swinging. That she just grounded out, so one on, two out. Top two. The 0-1 skips low and it gets by the catcher, Tyler Fliss. Nelson will move up to third. Anything in the outfield? That grass for Straighten will knock in Nelson. One ball, one strike. This one launched left center field. Caden Christensen moving over, backpedaling, and makes the catch on the run for out number three. No runs, no hits, no errors, one left on base. We'll head bottom two, 0-0 between the Highland Park Beavers and the Minneapolis Mudcats. Here on Prep Spotlight TV, we'll take you into the break, showing you some highlights from some of the other games so far here at the Town Ball Class A State Tournament. This one into left field. Branstad looks up. Walk off. In the bottom of the 15th. Hit a long way to left field. Wallert going back on it, and it is gone. Solo home run for Ben Suits, and he
got the number one and put the whistle on it. And it's 1-0. All three runs and have four hits so far. And there's a long drive to left field. Ulo going back, and he can't make the play at the fence. Fire him. Check that, Amundsen around third, and the throw is cut off at the plate, and it's a
busy trap. This one, fair down the third baseline. Coming in to score is Hoffman. Pockets will be waved around. He'll score. Sliding in left is Rowe. He blew out a tire, but got it back in. Bottom of the second inning, 0-0. Mudcats will have 7, 8, 9 due up in the order. Mitch Maurer back on the mound. That means it's Blaze Fairbanks, Tyler Fliss, and David Diamond up in the order for the Mudcats.
Number 24, Blaze Fairbanks.
Wave and a miss, strike one to the DH Fairbanks. Maurer yielded three singles in the first inning. Mudcats did not score. Maurer racked up three strikeouts in the inning. So kind of an up and down inning for Maurer in the first. Escaped though without any damage done, but did start to rack up the pitch count a little bit too. One ball, two strikes to Fairbanks. Foul tip, strike three. Fourth strikeout for Mitch Maurer. Three swinging, one looking so far.
Catcher now number 18, Tyler Fliss.
Brings up eight hole hitter, Tyler Fliss, starting catcher for the Mudcats. One out here, this one flared down the right side, it'll get foul. And over that fence down the first base side and clearly out of play. No ball, one strike. The bender didn't quite bend all the way back into the zone. It's 1-1. Fouled off the screen. And it's 1-2 to Tyler Fliss. Just early on here, bottom two. No runs, one hit, no errors for the Beavers. No runs, three hits, no errors for the Mudcats. Time called at the plate. Not sure what's going on here. Home plate umpire coming out to check the pitchers. Something, I don't know. I have no idea what that was about. That was odd. I don't know if they exchanged baseballs or not, but easier way to do that would have been to just throw him out another one and have him throw the other one back instead of making that play out. It kind of confused even the players on the field. The Beavers were kind of looking around at each other wondering what was going on. The 2-2, wave and a miss, strike three. That's the fifth strikeout so far for Mitch Maurer. All 5 outs recorded have been via the punchy. Brings up David Diamond, 9-hole hitter.
Stepping to the plate, 2014.
Playing
St.
third
Anthony
base.
Graduate. The third baseman, number 14, Dave Diamond.
So Diamond bats, 2 outs, bottom two. Awkward swing there for strike one. Maurer seems to have found his rhythm out there on the bump. Outside, evens up the count 1-1. One ball, one strike. That'll get foul, 1-2. This one into center field. Simon Hayek comes in, but charging out from second base is Alex Salim, and he makes the catch cap high for out number three. No runs, no hits, no errors, no one left on base. To the third inning we go, 0-0, Mudcats Beavers here on Prep Spotlight TV.
Jake Fleming.
9-1-2 due up for the Highland Park Beavers. Here in the top of the third, Logan McDonald back out there. Jake Fleming wearing the 00 jersey. Will bat first. Outside corner, strike one. Fleming, and then back to the top of the order with Corey Ryder and Simon Hayek. This one slashed foul, and it's 0-2. No balls, two strikes. Logan McDonald and Mitch Maurer both pitching very well so far here early on. This one off the foot of McDonald, makes the play, underhand flip, 1-3 for out number one. See if McDonald's all right, seems to be okay. Corey Ryder grounded out to shortstop to start this ball game, and no bat here for a second time in the top of the third inning.
Top of the order now for Highland Park, the first baseman, number 66, Corey Ryder.
See what Ryder has in store here for the Beavers. Goose eggs both sides of the scoreboard. Still early on, top three, one out. Curveball didn't bend back in. McDonald stretches things out after that pitch. The 1-0. No dice. Two balls, no strikes. Two and one. The 2-1. This one chopped too short. He's got a magnet out there on James Wolfel. Second time Ryder's grounded out to Wolfel at short, 6-3 for out number two. Brings up Simon Hayek. He grounded out to Matt Gerstner at second. In his first AB, wearing those retro socks. Hayek will dig in with nobody on and two outs in the top of the third. McDonald delivers. Upstairs, ball one. Come on. 2-0. Two balls, no strikes after two quick outs from Logan McDonald. See if he fights back here. Skips that one real low, and it's 3-0. Three balls, no strikes. Hayek walked him on four straight. Two-out walk to Simon Hayek will bring up Max Salim, who singled in the first inning as the only hit so far for the Beavers. Salim right back in there with two outs in the top of the third. One on, two out. Salim batting here in the top of the third. Singled, was stranded on first in the first. This one over to the third baseman, gobbled up. Diamond across the way. 5-3 for out number three. No runs, no hits, no errors. One left on base. Beavers have left one on base in each of the first three innings. We go to the bottom of the third. Mudcats will have a crack at it. 0-0. Town Ball Class A State Tournament here on Prep Spotlight TV.
What's special about high school sports? The passion. The excitement. The memories.
Now a three at the buzzer. Go!
It's about impacting your community. Connecting your business to this audience. This is where your customers live. Where they shop. This is their circle of life. This is where your business should be. Connect with your best potential customers. This is your invitation. Get in the game.
Bottom third, here we go. Top of the order, 1-2-3 due up for the Mudcats. Mitch Maurer has struck out five out of the six that he has retired. That includes Woeful, who struck out swinging in the first. Fouls that one off the screen, and it's one ball and one strike. Top of the order was able to chip away a little bit at Mitch Maurer. They had the bases loaded, did the Mudcats in the first inning with two outs after three singles. Were unable to push any runs across, though. Woeful gave a little tap of the bat after that one. Thought he might have just missed. Clubbing one deep into the outfield. Palm's Porch is filled up in right field above the 315 sign, right near the foul pole. Went off the mask of Straighten. We'll do it again at two balls and two strikes. The 2-2 from Maurer. Down low, count runs full. Three balls, two strikes. Maurer, the Woeful. Popped up first base side, out of play. This one punched into deep left. Jake Fleming goes back, looks up. It's gone. See ya. Solo shot for the Mudcats. James Woeful touch them all. 1-0. Minneapolis out in front.
Right fielder now, number 22, Avery.
Avery Nelson will dig in. He's got a single. Was left at third base back in the first inning, but the Mudcats jump out 1-0 here early on. Nelson. Saleem boots it. That'll be an E6. Nelson reaches first. Minneapolis has things cooking here in the bottom of the third inning.
First baseman, number 19, Milo Holmes.
This one down the third base line, foul. Milo Holmes almost tucked one in there in fair territory. Just couldn't quite get it on the right side of the bag. No balls, two strikes outside to Holmes. He singled in the first as well. Got stranded at second base. The 1-2, Holmes pops out of play. Pitch count getting up there for Mitch Maurer. He's recorded six outs, has now worked two plus. Five of those six outs via the punchy. But he's given up four hits, another has reached on an error. And he already had a wiggle out of a bases loaded jam in the first. Gave up a leadoff homer to James Wolfel here in the third. Mudcats lead 1-0. Popped up, first base side. Corey Ryder gives it a look. Ryder overran it at first base. That one stayed in play. And Ryder overran it over on the first base side. Had plenty of room over there at the end of the day. He was kind of hugging the fence. Didn't know if he'd have room, and then it bounced over to his right. Well into the play of field, but in foul territory. Second life for Holmes, grounded to second. Alex Saleem to Max Saleem over to first, and they turn the double play. 4-6-3, quickly two outs. That'll help the... pitch count there for Mitch Maurer getting a rollover double play.
Fielder number 23, Lucas Fleming.
Lucas Fleming bats, struck out in the first inning. Batting cleanup playing center field for the Mudcats, who lead 1-0, two outs, bottom three. Attacking the first pitch, center field, Simon Hayek. Called off by Matt Nelson, who comes over and makes the catch for out number three. Damage done, though, this inning. Solo shot from James Wolfel. One run. On one hit, one error, nobody left on base. Let's go to the fourth inning. 1-0 Mudcats over the Beavers here on Prep Spotlight TV.
Nobody does high school sports like PrepSpotlight.tv. Your home for Minnesota State tournament action is also where you can find the best weekly action during the regular season in 2021. We make it easy to be a high school sports fan at PrepSpotlight.tv.
Welcome back as we go to the fourth inning. This weekend's just the beginning of a great month of baseball in Minnesota. The Class BC tournaments get underway next Friday in Waconia, Chaska, and Hamburg. Folks, make sure to get out, support your community, or if you just love a game of baseball, want to watch winter go-home games at some fantastic venues, there's nothing like tournament time. If you can't make it to the games, prepspotlight.tv/townball has packages that'll make watching all the venues very affordable. Enjoy the tournament at the park or on prepspotlight.tv. Again, it's prepspotlight.tv/townball. Fourth inning we go. Solo shot from James Wolfel. The difference so far, 1-0 the lead for the Mudcats. Winner of this one will take on the Hogs of St. Anthony, who took out the Bloomington Bandits 5-1 earlier today. 5-6-7, check that. 4-5-6 due up in the order for the Beavers. Alex Salim, Matt Nelson, Andy Devine due up against Logan McDonald, the righty. Just one hit so far through three innings for the Beavers. Strike one. Foul tip, strike two. No balls, two strikes. Just missed upstairs. I think he was trying to locate that one center. And it just floated a little bit up high. Alex Salim leading off the fourth inning for the Beavers. Check swing, didn't want to. And it's fouled away. Just one strikeout so far for McDonald. His defense behind him has been sensational. A lot of balls put in play by the Beavers. Mudcats defense has been up to the task. This one fouled back. Tyler Fliss trying to make a play on it. Won't have one. We'll do it again at 1-2. One ball, two strikes. Fisted into right field. That's a fair ball. Fair ball for Alex Salim. He'll hang in with a leadoff single to start the fourth. It's the second hit so far for the Beavers. Gets things cooking here to start the inning.
Right fielder number 18, Matt Nelson.
One on, nobody out for Matt Nelson. Walked back in the second inning and was stranded at third base. Takes one inside here for ball one. Milo Holmes holding on. Salim over at first. Heater misses away and it's 2-0 to Nelson. Two balls, no strikes. From the stretch, the pitch, Nelson slaps it foul out of play to the right. Alex Salim on first, a leadoff single on a flare shot down the right field line. Short lead over at the bag, Holmes holding him on. McDonald trying to fight back in the count against Nelson. Breaking ball, peppers the zone, and it's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. McDonald's pitch. Upstairs, full count. We'll see if Salim is on the move. 3-2 count, but still nobody out. Top of the fourth inning. The 3-2 from McDonald. We'll do it again. Nelson fighting hard. Old school look with the no batting gloves. Rocking the mustache up top is Matt Nelson. Starting right fielder, hitting in that five hole for the Highland Park Beavers here this afternoon. Runner not off. Pitch is taken down low. Two walks for Nelson so far. He's on first. Salim moves up to second. Two on, nobody out. Tap four for Andy Devine.
Third baseman number 17, Andy Devine.
So Devine bats here. He struck out swinging. It's the only strikeout for McDonald so far. Devine did that back in the second inning. Bats here in a good spot with two on and nobody out. Showing bunt. Went under the legs of Tyler Fliss. Both runners move up a bag. So Devine certainly won't be bunting here, at least you wouldn't think, now that both runners have moved up via the wild pitch. Second and third, nobody out. Pitch was ruled a strike. As they said, Devine squared around and didn't bring it back. So it's no balls, one strike. McDonald, make it 0-2. The 0-2 for McDonald. Check swing. Down to third base. Plays coming home. And they rule him safe. Salim slides in under the tag from Fliss. Nelson to third. Devine to first on that fielder's choice. So Salim comes in to score, and it's 1-1.
Designated hitter now, number 12, Pat Shahey.
Designated hitter Pat Shee's up. Grounded out to second base in his first at bat. Runners on the corner, still nobody out, top four. First pitch from Logan McDonald to the second baseman. Runner will come in to score. Gerstner's only plays to first because it was hit so slowly. So Devine moves up to second. The force out is at first for out number one. But it's now a 2-1 lead for the Highland Park Beavers.
With one away, the catcher, number six, Zach Straighten.
So that'll get the job done for Sheehy. Zach Straighten comes up, he's 0-1. Runner on second is Devine. 2-1 lead for the Beavers here in the top of the fourth. Ball low. One ball, no strikes. Ooh, and it hit him. Hit him in the back, it looked like. Right near the back, the upper back in the neck area. There for Straighten. Straighten taking a moment here. Might have kicked in late there. Looked like he was initially just going to walk it off down the first base line. He already took a foul ball right off his mask. Those catchers are tough. Straighten going to try to walk it off down to first base. Runners on first and second, one out. It'll bring up Jake Fleming.
Left fielder, number 00, Jake Fleming.
So Fleming up, two on, one out, a long top of the fourth inning here. Beavers have already brought in two runs looking for more. Fleming grounded out to McDonald in his first at bat. This one chased it up high into the hole at short. Long throw across the diamond. They rule him out at first. Bang, bang play over at first base. Fleming ruled out 6-3. James Wolfel showing off the cannon of an arm for out number two. I think Fleming just realized he was called out. He was standing on first. Back to the top of the order we go with Corey Ryder.
Top of the order now.
He is grounded out to short, both ABs so far. Opportunity here to really put a stamp on this inning for the Beavers. Already two in, but two more in scoring position with two down. Good block down low by Fliss. Ball one. One ball, no strikes. High and tight for ball two to Ryder. Big moment in this game. McDonald trying to keep it at 2-1. Ryder trying to capitalize. Breaking ball in there for a strike, 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Here we go. This one into right center field. Nelson over to his right. Makes the catch for a big third out. Damage done, though, in the top half of the fourth inning. Two runs come in, just one hit. No errors, two left on base. Bottom four we go. 2-1. Beavers over the Mudcats here on Prep Spotlight TV. First pitch to Max Gerstner. Slapped into the hole over at short. Throw across the way, safe! Gerstner in there. Max Salim's throw to Corey Ryder, not in time. Lead off infield single. Start the bottom of the fourth inning. Mitch Maurer back out there.
Now batting
for the Beavers.
Number 16, Caden Christensen.
Caden Christensen struck out looking. To end the first inning, bats here, one on, nobody out, bottom four. One run on five hits for the Mudcats, no errors. Two runs, two hits, one error for the Beavers. They lead by one. Runner off for second. Pitch is low, throw down to second. Off the mark, wouldn't have been in time anyways. Gerstner nabs second base with nobody out here, bottom four. Mudcats looking to strike back and at minimum tie this one up this inning now. Runner on second, nobody out. Fastball stays high and away, 2-1. in right field, base hit. Looks like they're going to send Gerstner, and they will. The throw comes in, and now Gerstner holds up at third. Good backup there by the pitcher, Mitch Maurer, as that throw from Matt Nelson and right sailed well over the mark. Gerstner at third. Christensen at first after the single. Back-to-back singles to start the bottom of the fourth. Blaze Fairbanks from Albat. Designated hitter in the seventh spot in the lineup. 0-for-1 struck out swinging. Lefty on lefty, runners on the corners, nobody out. Mudcats trying to answer the Beavers, putting up two in the top half of the frame. Infield single, runner off for first, and then one that was ticketed for right field from Caden Christensen. Mudcats have things in business as the second base is stolen by Christensen. No throw down. Second and third, nobody out. Bottom four. Perfect placement there. Inside corner for strike two. One ball, two strikes. This one in a right field, that's a base hit. Gerstner comes in to score. They're going to send Christensen as well. Throw to the plate. Christensen's out. Good throw in for Matt Nelson. It is an RBI single, though, for Blaze Fairbanks. And it knots things up at two apiece.
Catcher with one away, number 18, Tyler Fliss.
Tyler Fliss bats one on, one out. They could have had, you know, runners on the corners, nobody out. They decided to send Christensen, who was out by a mile, as Matt Nelson came up gunning from right field. So runner on first, one out, a 2-2 affair. First pitch popped foul by Tyler Fliss. Back and forth game so far here in game two. Game one, the Hogs of St. Anthony never trailed. Two-run homer in the first, three-run homer in the eighth. Went on to win 5-1. One ball, one strike now to Fliss. 0-for-1 with a punchy. Short lead at first over there for Fairbanks, being held on by Ryder. Southpaw has a look over and deals. Check swing. They say he went around for strike two. One ball, two strikes to the catcher, Tyler Fliss. One, two. Little jam shot, slow roller over to second. They get the out at first. Fairbanks moves up to second on the 4-3 put out for out number two. Brings up David Diamond. Popped out
with two away
to Alex Salim at second.
University of Minnesota alumni and the third baseman, number 14, Dave Diamond.
Base knock. Good score, Fairbanks. If Diamond's able to place one into the outfield grass. Two outs, awkward swing there for strike one. No balls, one strike. No balls, two strikes. Maurer steps off, shook off his catcher, Zach Straighten, a couple of times. We'll try to get on the same page here. No balls, two strikes. Here's the pitch. Wave and a miss, strike three, Diamond goes down. Mudcats tied up, though. One run on three hits. No errors. One left on base. Let's go to the fifth inning. 2-2 here on Prep Spotlight TV.
All summer long, you have gathered with friends, neighbors, and family at ball yards all across Minnesota.
Still going, gone, a home run!
Diamonds that decorate and help define hundreds of communities. Town Ball binds together our passion for baseball in our hometowns. And on September 11th, the cornerstone of Minnesota baseball, Target Field, will host a party for all those who play, watch, and support Town Ball. The Twins host the Royals at 6:10 p.m. Prior to the game, the newly crowned state amateur champs will be honored at the Town Ball Tavern and during a pregame ceremony. Wear your team colors and enjoy a special night at Target Field.
The 0-2 pitch. Strike three! Belmont! State champions in 2020!
For tickets to the Twins' tip of the cap to Town Ball on September 11th, visit twinsbaseball.com/townball.
Fifth inning we go. 2-2 between the Minneapolis Mudcats and the Highland Park Beavers. Town Ball Class A State Tournament, thanks for making us a part of your Sunday afternoon plans. Picture perfect day at Palm Field. Thanks for tuning in to Prep Spotlight TV. 2-3-4 due up here in the fifth. Logan McDonald back out there, wheeling, dealing.
Simon Hayek.
For the Mudcats, Simon Hayek will lead off. 0-1 with a walk. 2-2 in the fifth inning. Mudcats got to be kicking themselves a little bit. They have 7 hits, just 2 runs. Beavers have 2 runs on just 2 hits. Hayek takes a strike there, and it's 0-1. That one skips low and it's 1-1. Hayek reached on that walk in the third and was left at first base. Inside and it's 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Fouled at the plate, and it's 2-2. Hayek leading off here in the top of the fifth. 2-2 contest. Winner will take on the Hogs of St. Anthony, who won earlier today against the Bloomington Bandits by a final score of 5-1. Full count here to Hayek to start the fifth. McDonald winds and delivers ball 4. Hayek reaches again via a walk here in the fifth inning.
Shortstop now, number 24, Max Salim.
Salim 1-for-2 with a single. McDonald now works from the stretch. First pitch right down Main Street, strike 1 to Max Salim. Off for second, swing and a miss, throw it out of the bag, not in time. Hayek into second base safely with nobody out here in the top of the fifth.
Come on, Max, move him around. RBI.
No balls, 2 strikes to Max Salim. Alex Salim waits on deck. McDonald's pitch. Took a weird hop off the bat to short. They're not going to have a play. Over at first base. Now runners on the corners with nobody out. Infield single.
Batting now, number 34.
for Max Saleem. Runners in the corners, nobody out for Alex Saleem, who's 1-for-2, singled, came around to score back in inning to go in the fourth. Big spot here for the Beavers, try to capitalize and regain the lead. High and tight, ball one. Off-speed pitch stays up, and it's 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. The pitch. Into the hole, RBI single. Alex Saleem comes up big. Highland Park jumps back up in front, 3-2. Matt Nelson will bat, two on, still nobody out, top of the fifth, 3-2 is the lead. Looks like we're going to get some action down there in the Minneapolis Mudcats bullpen. Nelson, two walks so far in this one, came around to score in the fourth. McDonald needs to find a way to get some outs. Nelson shows bunt, pops it back off the screen. No balls, one strike. See if Nelson's bunting here. Swinging away.
Okay, Nelly, you got this.
It's 0-2. O-2, slap to short, Wolfel over to his right. They get the out at second, relay throw to first, and it's in time. Nelson can't believe he was called out. 6-4-3 on the double play. Max Saleem makes it over to third, but there's two outs.
With two away, third baseman number 17, Andy Devine.
So one on, two outs for Andy Devine. That was a big, big get there for Logan McDonald. Looked like it could have been a huge inning. Still could be for the Beavers, but now you got runner on third with two outs when they had first and second, nobody out, and one already in. First pitch to Devine. Slapped at the second baseman. Easy play for Gerstner on to first. And Logan McDonald able to wiggle out of it with just one run given up in the inning. One run, two hits. No errors, one left on base. Bottom five we go. Beavers lead the Mudcats 3-2 on Prep Spotlight TV. We'll take you into the break, showing you some highlights from some of the earlier Town Ball State Tournament games here from Palms Field. This one into left field. Branstad looks up. Walk off! In the bottom of the 15th.
Here he comes. Hit a long way to left field. Wallard going back on it, and it is gone. Solo home run for Ben Suits, and he got the number one and put the whistle on it. And it's 1-0. All three runs and have four hits so far. There's a long drive to left field. Ulo going back, and he can't make the play at the fence. Hiram checked out Amundson around third, and the throw is cut off at the plate, and it's a
fair down the third baseline. Coming in to score is Hoffman. Poppets will be waved around. He'll score. Sliding in left is Rowe. He blew out a tire but got it back in. Bottom five. Maurer delivers. Ground ball over to second. Easy play, 4-3. As James Wolfel's retired for out number one.
With one away,
3-2 lead for the Beavers over the Mudcats. Back and forth seesaw battle. Mudcats led 1-0. Beavers led 2-1. Then it was 2-2. Now it's 3-2 in favor of Highland Park. Got a feeling we haven't seen the last of the scoring yet in this one. Don't really feel like I'm sticking my neck out with a bold prediction saying that either. Mitch Maurer delivers ball one to Avery Nelson, who has reached base twice, single, and reached down an error as well. Lefty on lefty.
Oh, nice!
You betcha. Great pitch there.
Woo-hoo!
From Maurer. One ball, one strike. Outside edge, strike two. Maurer's starting to let it rip here, bottom five.
There it is. Good job.
Nelson. Able to stay alive. Big play in this one came last inning. Mudcats had first and third, nobody out. RBI single knocked in one, moved the other up to third. Checked that to second. So then it was 2-2, runners on first and second with nobody out, and a single was knocked into right field, but Caden Christensen ended up getting gunned at the plate.
There you go, Pitch. Keep it up.
It kind of sucked some of the momentum. Took the wind out of the sails, however you want to chop it up with the Mudcats. Just a 3-2 game though here, bottom five, one out. 2-2 is the count to Avery Nelson, the right fielder. Full count. Milo Holmes waits on deck. He's 1-2. The 3-2. Wave it a miss, strike three.
Oh, nice job, pitcher.
Seventh strikeout from Mitch Maurer so far through 4 2/3 innings.
With two away.
Brings up Milo Holmes.
First baseman number 19, Milo Holmes.
Palm Field, the site here in St. Anthony. Town Ball Class A State Tournament. Palm's porch out there in right field. Packed up. Good amount of fans out there on the porch. This one lofted into right center field. Matt Nelson calls everyone off in right field. Cap high catch. Three up, three down. Here in the bottom of the fifth. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on base. On to the sixth inning we go. 3-2. Highland Park leading the Minneapolis Mudcats here on Prep Spotlight TV.
What's special about high school sports? The passion. The excitement. The memories.
Down a three at the buzzer. Go! It's good! DuBois wins it for the Rebels!
It's about impacting your community. Connecting your business to this audience. This is where your customers live, where they shop. This is their circle of life. This is where your business should be. Connect with your best potential customers. This is your invitation. Get in the game.
Seven, eight, nine, due up, top six. There you go. Palm's porch out there in right field. Look at that spot. Here at Palm Field in St. Anthony. Right above that 315 sign in right field. Sixth inning we go. Highland Park Beavers lead the Minneapolis Mudcats 3-2 here on Prep Spotlight TV Town Ball Class A State Tournament. Mitch Widmeyer helping you bring some of the coverage here for games one and two. We have two more games coming up after that, this afternoon and then tonight. Logan McDonald back out there on the bump. Ball one low to Pat Sheehy. 0 for 2 has grounded out to Max Gerstner, excuse me, at second base twice, so he's 0 for 2. McDonald's pitch, you bet, strike one. Great off-speed pitch for strike two. Speaking of Gerstner at second, you know, top six, nobody out. We've seen 15 outs recorded by pitcher Logan McDonald of the Mudcats. This one into left field, charging in. Christensen makes the sliding grab. Okay, so now we've seen 16 outs. Just looking at the scorecard, there have been five hit to Max Gerstner at second base that he's recorded. There's been a 4-4-3 putouts and then a 4-6-3 double play. Brings up Zach Straighten here with one out, top six. 0-for-1, he was hit by a pitch. Yeah. Weird spot, you don't see it often. It was like his back of his neck, top of his back area. He initially started making his way down the first baseline, then I think the stinger must have kicked in because he ended up going down and punching over down that first base line a little bit. But he did stay in the game. He's a catcher. Knew he wasn't going to come out. He's ahead in the count here, 2-0. McDonald from the wind, the pitch. Two balls and a strike. Wave and a miss. Big hack there from Straighten. 2-0 count goes to 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, one out, the pitch. Wave and a miss, strike three. Two quick outs here in the top of the six for Logan McDonald. Brings up Jake Fleming, who's 0 for 2 with a couple of ground outs.
Left fielder now, number 0, Jake Fleming.
Beavers have left runners on in each and every inning. So far this inning, nobody on. Two outs, top six. They left one on in the first, one in the second, one in the third, two in the fourth, and one in the fifth. They've gotten base runners on early and often in this one. They've pushed across three runs to lead by one so far over the Mudcats. Peeking ahead to the bottom half of the inning, it'll be 4-5-6 due up in the order for the Minneapolis Mudcats. The 2-0. Got him to chase. It's 2-1. Three balls and one strike. Two outs, top six. Fleming, the nine-hole hitter, trying to jolt the offense here with two outs. Fouls it off the screen, and it's 3-2. Corey Ryder on deck, the leadoff hitter. He's 0-for-3. Would love a chance here in the sixth. That one hits Fleming with two outs. So Ryder will get that chance. Runner on first, two outs. Ryder's 0-for-3.
Top of the order for the Beavers.
Ryder, two ground outs and a fly out so far.
Ryder.
Trying to break through here. Corey. Wave it a miss, strike one. Fleming short lead over at first, held on the bag by Milo Holmes. Speed pitch upstairs, and it's 1-1. A couple of arms loosening up in the Mudcats bullpen. If McDonald records this third out, could be the end of the line for him. He's gone 5 2/3 so far, trying to look at an even 6 straight innings recorded. Ahead in the count now, 1-2 on Ryder. One ball, two strikes. Runner off for second. Ryder slaps it to short. Wolfel, strong arm across the diamond. That's the third time Ryder has grounded out to the shortstop. No runs, no hits, no errors. Another one left on base for the Beavers. We will head bottom six. 3-2 here on Prep Spotlight TV. Bottom six, Mudcats trail by one. First pitch, attacking. Fleming grounds over to third. 5-3, out number one. So Fleming, 0-3. Attacking that first pitch from Mitch Maurer.
Second baseman now, number 10, Max Gerstner.
Good part of the order, up 4-5-6. Now it's the five-hole hitter, Max Gerstner, who's 2-for-2 with a couple of singles. He attacks the first pitch. This one fouled down the right side. Two runs, seven hits, no errors for the Mudcats, who trail 3-2. Speaking of that three, Highland Park Beavers, three runs, four hits, one error. Bunt down the third base side. Devine going to have a tough play. He's going to just let it go. He was going to see if it would trickle foul. It didn't. Gerstner 3-for-3 with three singles. So Gerstner thriving, styling, profiling in that five-hole spot. 3-for-3.
Caden Christensen
steps in, 1-for-2 with a single. One out, bottom of the sixth. Maurer, the lefty, working from the stretch now. Fastball outside, 1-0. See how aggressive Gerstner gets over there at first base. Down one, bottom six. Fouled off the screen for strike one. One ball, one strike. Christensen's hit was a single in his last at-bat. Runner is off for second. Throw down. They call him out. Gerstner can't believe it. Close play at the bag. Gerstner called out for out number two with the count is 1-2. That was a strike to Christensen. One ball, two strikes. That'll help out Mitch Maurer. Check swing off the screen. Two outs here now quickly, bottom six. Gerstner thought he was safe. It was a bang-bang play down there at second. Strike three looking. Christensen gets caught looking for the second time. No runs, one hit, no errors, nobody left on base. Move along to the seventh inning. Highland Park leading the Mudcats 3-2 here on Prep Spotlight TV.
Nobody does high school sports like PrepSpotlight.tv. Your home for Minnesota State tournament action is also where you can find the best weekly action during the regular season in 2021. We make it easy to be a high school sports fan at PrepSpotlight.tv.
This weekend's just the beginning of a great month of baseball in Minnesota. The Class BC tournaments get underway next Friday in Waconia, Chaska, and Hamburg. Get out and support your community, or if you just love the game of baseball and want to watch win or go home games at fantastic venues, there's nothing like tournament time. Folks, if you can't make it to the games, prepspotlight.tv/townball has packages that'll make watching at the venues very affordable. Enjoy the tournament at the park or on prepspotlight.tv. Again, it's prepspotlight.tv/townball. Logan McDonald, you know, they've had action in the bullpen the last couple innings, but McDonald's going to start the top of this seventh inning out on the mound. He's pitched pretty well so far. Just four hits for the Beavers, but it's been enough so far as they lead 3-2 in the seventh inning. Two, three, four due up in the order for the Beavers. Means we're going to see Simon Hayek, Max Salim, and Alex Salim. Hayek due first, 0-for-1 with two walks. Walked in the fifth, would come around to score later on. That was the last run scored in this game. Beavers lead 3-2.
Leading off for the Beavers, center fielder number 20, Simon Hayek.
Hayek leading off the top of the seventh inning. Breaking ball in the zone for strike one. Off the plate inside, it's 1-1.
Drive it, Simon.
That was a good pitch, Logan.
Let's see what the leash is here on Logan McDonald. There's a righty down there in the bullpen still for the Mudcats, getting loose. Off-speed pitch, punch to short. Good pick by Wolfel across the way. Home is got his foot down on the bag in time. 6-3 for out number one. Another bang-bang play. Basehump has had a heck of a day. A lot of close calls in this one. One up, one down for Max Salim.
With one away, the shortstop number 24, Max Salim.
Salim 2-for-3, couple of singles. One out here, top seven. Outside corner, strike one. Fouled off the screen, 0-2. One out here, top seven. Max Salim, the shortstop, 2-for-3, couple of singles. The 0-2. Wave and a miss, awkward swing there, strike three. Throw down to first in, plenty of time for out number two. Alex Salim now comes up, 2-for-3. Two singles, one of them an RBI single. Back in the fifth inning, his single in the fourth, he would later come around to score a run. Logan McDonald still pitching effectively and efficiently. Two outs, top seven. Gave a little smile out there on the mound after that breaking ball stayed up high. Count is 1-0. That one downstairs, 2-0. Peeking ahead to the bottom half, it'll be 7-8-9. Fairbanks, Fliss, Diamond due up in the inning for the Mudcats. Work left to be done here, though. Alex Salim lifts left field. Caden Christensen over to his left. Cap high catch for out number three. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on base. Mudcats need to get going a little bit down 3-2 here on PrepSpotlight.tv.
All summer long, you have gathered with friends, neighbors, and family at ball yards all across Minnesota.
Still going, gone, a home run!
Diamonds that decorate and help define hundreds of communities. Town Ball binds together our passion for baseball in our hometowns. And on September 11th, the cornerstone of Minnesota baseball, Target Field, will host a party for all those who play, watch, and support Town Ball. The Twins host the Royals at 6:10 p.m. Prior to the game, the newly crowned state amateur champs will be honored at the Town Ball Tavern and during a pregame ceremony. Wear your team colors and enjoy a special night at Target Field.
The 0-2 pitch. Strike three! Fairmont! State champions in 2020!
Congratulations to the Fairmont Martins. They are your 2020!
For tickets to the Twins' tip of the cap to Town Ball on September 11th, visit twinsbaseball.com/townball.
Fairbanks fouls out of play. To start the bottom of the seventh inning. Fairbanks lifts into left field. Catch is made though for out number one.
With one away, the catcher, number 18, Tyler Fliss.
Tyler Fliss up with one out. After Fairbanks flew out to Jake Fleming. At one, foul. From Tyler Fliss, who's 0 for 2. Mitch Maurer still out there wheeling and dealing. The lefty. Working a heck of a game so far for the Beavers. One stays below the knees. It's 1-1 to the catcher, Fliss. Struck out in the second, grounded out to second in the fourth. Highland Park leading 3-2. The 1-1, outside corner. One ball, two strikes. Maurer gets the sign from straight, delivers, popped over to the right side. Corey Ryder gives it a look, gets underneath it, and makes the catch for out number two. Wind got a hold of that one at the end. Ryder had some issues earlier on with a pop-up in foul territory that landed harmlessly that he probably should have caught, definitely should have caught. But makes the play on that one. Two outs here, bottom seven. Fastball inside corner, strike one. Maurer's 0-1, foul tip, strike two. Pinch hitter up there is Brody Schneider pinch hitting. Check swing appealed out of first. He did not go. Schneider pinch hitting for David Diamond, who went 0 for 2. Two outs here, bottom seven. Highland Park leads 3-2, outside corner. Missed off the plate, 2-2. Both starting pitchers giving some great efforts out there on the rubber today. Not sure where that one missed. Ooh. Three balls and two strikes. Foul tip. Man, Straighten's had a rough day. He has taken a couple foul balls off the mask and got hit in the back earlier on in this game as well. Three balls, two strikes. Maurer to Schneider. Just missed high. Activity in the Beavers bullpen as well. Two outs here. We'll flip it back over to the top of the order with James Wolfel. So Wolfel bats. Two outs, bottom seven. Hit a solo home run back in the third. Tying run now on base for the Mudcats. Strike one to Wolfel. Two runs on eight hits. No errors for the Mudcats. Three runs, four hits, one error for the Beavers. Outside corner, strike two. Not much of a lead at first base for Schneider. Now he's extending it out a little bit. He is being held on the bag by Ryder. The 0-2. Slapped to third. Devine throws on to second. Makes the shorter throw. Same result. Out number three as it works 5-6 and retires the side. No runs, no hits, no errors. One left on base. Eighth inning we go. Highland Park leading 3-2 here on PrepSpotlight.tv. We'll take in the break showing you highlights from some of the earlier games here in this state tournament. To left field. Branstad looks up. Walk off. In the bottom of the 15th. Hit a long way to left field. Wallard going back on it, and it is gone. Solo home run for Ben Suits, and he got the number one and put the whistle on it. And it's 1-0. All three runs and four hits so far. It's a long drive to left field. Ulo going back, and he can't make the play at the fence. Hiram, check that, Amundson around third, and the throw is cut off at the plate, and it's a
easy track. This one
fair down the third baseline. Coming in to score is Hoffman. Poppets will be waved around. He'll score. Sliding in left is Rowe. He blew out a tire, but got it back.
On the mound now for the Mudcats, number 32, Harrison Blum.
Eighth inning we go. Might have just heard the announcement. Logan McDonald goes
off for the Beavers.
Seven strong innings.
Right fielder number 18.
His day is done.
Nelson.
As the Mudcats go to the bullpen with Harrison Blum, the righty. So Harrison Blum in to take over here in the top of the eighth. He will start by facing Matt Nelson, the right fielder, who takes one right to center field, and it'll land in front of Lucas Fleming. Leadoff single for Nelson, who's been on base three times, but that's his first hit. Had walked twice, hit into a 6-4-3 double play in the fifth, and now has a single here in the eighth. So one on, nobody out for the Beavers. We'll get you those final tallies from McDonald here in a second. As he pitched very well for the Mudcats here this afternoon. Team does trail by one, though.
Number
1-0 from Blum. Wave and a miss from Andy Devine, who's 0-3 so far. Final line for Logan McDonald. 7 innings, 4 hits, 3 runs, 6 free passes, 3 strikeouts for the righty for the Mudcats. Harrison Blum in relief. Matt Nelson, good lead from first. Blum delivers. Foul ball. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Beavers lead 3-2. Top 8 winner will take on the Hogs of St. Anthony, who took out the Bloomington Bandits 5-1 earlier here today. Ball, 2 strikes. Check swing, he went around, strike 3. Blum strikes out Devine for out number 1. Brings up Pat Sheehy, who's 0-3 in that designated hitter spot. One on, one out. Outside corner, strike 1 on the heater. Action down the left side, the Highland Park bullpen. Mitch Maurer has pitched 7 strong. We'll see if he goes back out there for an 8th inning or not. Highland Park trying to tack on some insurance runs. The 0-1, upstairs, high and tight. 1 ball, 1 strike to Sheehy. Runner on first, Matt Nelson. Good lead over at the bag being held on by Milo Holmes. The 1-1, chopped right side. It's gonna be a tough play. They throw it over to first for the out as Pat Sheehy wasn't really running down the line. Looked like it was ticketed for an infield single, but instead it's a 6-3 put out, but Matt Nelson does move up to second base. So runner on second, 2 outs for Zach Straighten, who's 0-2 with a hit by pitch. Top of the 8th inning, Highland Park leading 3-2. First pitch, ball 1. Looking ahead to the bottom half of the 8th, it'll be the 2-3-4 hitters due up for the Mudcats. Harrison Blum trying to keep it at a 3-2 game for Minneapolis.
Come on, Harry, smoke him.
Two balls, no strikes. Pitch from Blum. Strike 1. Swing and a miss, strike 2 to Straighten. Nelson's getting a good lead over there at second. Gerstner's checking in once in a while. At least trying to keep him honest over there on the bag. The 2-2 from Blum. Avery Nelson, Milo Holmes, Lucas Fleming are due up bottom 8. They're a combined 2-for-9 with 2-3-4 hitters for the Mudcats today. 2-2. Got him to chase, strike 3. No runs, 1 hit, no errors, 1 left on base. Highland Park has left a runner on at least 1 in 7 out of the 8 innings. Bottom 8, Mudcats will have a shot at it. Down 3-2, Town Ball Class A State Tournament here on Prep Spotlight TV.
What's special about high school sports? The passion. the excitement. The memories.
Down on three at the buzzer. Go! It's good! DuBois wins it for the Rebels!
It's about impacting your community. Connecting your business to this audience. This is where your customers live. Where they shop. This is their circle of life. This is where your business should be. Connect with your best potential customers. This is your invitation. Get in the game.
Bottom of the eighth inning. You see it on your screen. Mitch Maurer will start the inning back on the mound. He's worked seven innings of two-run ball so far. 2-3-4 are due up for the Mudcats. Avery Nelson is 1-for-3. Lefty on lefty to start. One ball, one strike to Nelson, the right fielder. His hit came all the way back in the first inning. Since then, reached on an error in the third, struck out swinging in the fifth. Bottom eight, Highland Park leads 3-2. Strike two. Called strike there to Nelson. One ball, two strikes. Upstairs, 2-2. Again, winner of this will play the Hogs of St. Anthony. Took out the Bloomington Bandits 5-1. Three-run homer and a two-run homer. All the Hogs needed to win that one by four. Nelson through the right side. Leadoff single here in the eighth. Brings up Milo Holmes, who's 1-for-3. Big spot here. Leadoff batter gets on base. Looks like we might have a change to the bullpen. Mitch Maurer will give way. He goes 7+. We'll get you new info on the pitcher coming up after this break here on Prep Spotlight TV.
Celebrate the end of the 2021 Town Ball season. Join your teammates, rivals, and ball fans from around the state at the Twins game on September 11th. Special ticket pricing for Town Ball players and fans, salutes to the newly crowned champs, and a very fun night at the ballpark. Order your tickets at twinsbaseball.com/townball and wear your town's team colors to Target Field on September 11th. Nobody does high school sports like PrepSpotlight.tv. Your home for Minnesota State tournament action is also where you can find the best weekly action during the regular season in 2021. We make it easy to be a high school sports fan at PrepSpotlight.tv.
New pitcher out there is Jared Schmidt for the Highland Park Brewers. Day is done for Mitch Maurer. Book not closed yet, though. He is responsible now for that runner on first. After the runner on first after the single by Avery Nelson. Maurer did go 7+, 9 hits, runs to be determined based off that runner on first. 7 strikeouts, 1 walk issued out by Mitch Maurer, who was pretty dang good in this one for the Beavers. And now Jared Schmidt comes in and needs to record 6 outs for the Beavers. Milo Holmes will be the batter as he's timing things up. Runner on first, nobody out, bottom eight. It's 3-2, Highland Park leading Minneapolis. Town Ball Class A State Tournament here at Palm Field.
Highland Park number 15, Jared Schmidt. And for Mudcats number 19, Milo Holmes.
Schmidt's first pitch slapped foul by Milo Holmes. Holmes singled in the first, grounded into a double play in the third, flew out to Matt Nelson in right in the fifth. Big spot here, just got a piece and it's 0-2. Nelson led off with a single. He's on first base with nobody out. High and tight for ball one. Wave and a miss, strike three. Schmidt gets Holmes for out number one. Big first out. Lucas Fleming coming to the dish. He's 0 for 3. He's gotten out in each and every way. He has struck out, flown out, grounded out. Bats with a runner on first. Bottom eight, one out. First pitch scoots away from straight, and Nelson will move up to second base. I believe they called that a ball inside, and they did. So one ball, no strikes to Lucas Fleming, the center fielder. Runner now in scoring position, the tying run. One out, bottom eight. Schmidt's pitch, that's a strike. Fleming looking fooled on these first two pitches. One ball, one strike. Foul tip, strike two. A 1-2 from Schmidt. Fleming had to duck out of the way of that one. Good snag behind the dish by Straighten. Save that one from going to the backstop. The 2-2. Down low, blocked by Straighten. It's 3-2. Max Gerstner waits on deck. He is 3 for 3 with three singles. Licking his chops at an opportunity to bat with at least one on this inning, potentially more. Three balls, two strikes to Fleming. Schmidt's pitch, not even close, ball four. Two on, one out for Max Gerstner.
Number 10, Max
has
Gerstner.
A third of the hits for the Mudcats, three out of their nine. Came around to score once back in inning number four. Nelson at second, Fleming at first, one out, bottom eight. Big moment in this one. First pitch, ball outside to Gerstner. Schmidt could use a ground ball double play here. Mudcats are gonna try to split a gap. The 1-0, 2-0. Schmidt not hitting his marks here. Behind in the count. Two balls, no strikes. Gerstner took a rip at that one and fouled it back. 2-1. Wind is howling now here at Palm Field. Two balls, one strike. Schmidt peeks at the runner at second, now delivers home. Outside corner for strike two. Dirschner hopped out of the box. Silent protest there of that call. 2-2. Big strike there for Schmidt. This one lofted left center field. Simon Hayek runs over, called off by the left fielder Jake Fleming, who makes the catch for out number two. Throwback to second, not in time. But a big second out there for Jared Schmidt and the Beavers. Brings up Caden Christensen, has struck out looking twice. Singled in the fourth and was then thrown out at home. Looking back at that play at the plate now, could have big ramifications here in a one-run game, bottom eight. For now though, Christensen, chance to step up. Two on, two out, attacks the first pitch into center field. It lands in front of Simon Huck. They're gonna wave Avery Nelson. Huck, Hayek's throw to the plate, and it is in time, he's out at the dish. Oh my goodness. Simon Hayek comes up gunning. Avery Nelson out at the dish. What a play. 3-2. We go to the ninth inning coming up next here on Prep Spotlight TV.
All summer long, you have gathered with friends, neighbors, and family at ball yards all across Minnesota.
Still going, gone, a home run!
Diamonds that decorate and help define hundreds of communities. Town Ball binds together our passion for baseball in our hometowns. And on September 11th, the cornerstone of Minnesota baseball, Target Field, will host a party for all those who play, watch, and support Town Ball. The Twins host the Royals at 6:10 p.m. Prior to the game, the newly crowned state amateur champs will be honored at the Town Ball Tavern and during a pregame ceremony. Wear your team colors and enjoy a special night at Target Field.
The 0-2 pitch. Strike three! Fairmont! State champions in 2020!
Congratulations to the Fairmont Martins. They are your 2020!
For tickets to the Twins' tip of the cap to Town Ball on September 11th, visit twinsbaseball.com/townball.
Ninth inning we go, Highland Park leading 3-2 after a bang-bang play at the plate. Avery Nelson gunned down by Simon Hayek, keeping this score at 3-2 in favor of the Beavers. Harrison Blumback out there pitching for the Mudcats. This one grounded in the hole at the left side. It's a leadoff single in the ninth for Jake Fleming. Jake Fleming leadoff single. Turn it back over to the top of the lineup with Corey Ryder, who's 0-for-4 and has grounded out to the shortstop three times.
Batting now number 66, Corey Ryder.
So see if Ryder can crack through here. Highland Park looking to provide some insurance runs. Ball one outside to Ryder. Grounded out to short in the first, third, and sixth. Flew out to Avery Nelson in right field in the fourth. One ball, one strike. Check that, one ball, no strikes to Ryder. One misses upstairs. Ryder will look to square something up here on a 2-0 count. Good lead at first for Jake Fleming. Blum delivers. Outside edge, strike one. Two balls, one strike. Downstairs, 3-1. Hitters count here for Ryder. You know Blum doesn't want to let him go and have first and second. Nobody out to start the ninth. Mudcats already trailing by one. The 3-1. Walked him. Two on, nobody out to start the top of the ninth. Simon Hayek, who threw out Nelson at the plate to end the bottom of the eighth. Bats here in a good spot with two on, nobody out, top nine.
Pitch running now at first, number 21, Jimmy Shiggins.
See if Hayek's laying down a bunt here. They're swinging away. He's 0 for 2, has two walks. He is showing bunt. Bunts through it for strike one.
Come on, Sy.
No balls, one strike. Beavers trying to add insurance runs, leading 3-2 here in the top of the ninth inning. The 0-1 shows bunt again, pulls it back for ball one. Milo Holmes is in at first. Third baseman back at his normal depth. Bunt is laid down. Hayek was tagged at first. Holmes lost the ball during the transfer. But the job gets done there for Hayek as Fleming moves up to third. Ryder's courtesy runner moves up to second on a great sacrifice bunt from Hayek. Second and third, one out for Max Salim. 2 for 4, couple of singles. Golden opportunity here for Highland Park to add to their 3-2 lead.
Batting now, number 24, Max Salim.
Fastball upstairs. Big spot here for both sides. Blum could use a strikeout. Salim just trying to put one even deep enough into the outfield to score a run. This one gets through the defense that was played in. One run will score. They'll send home the second run. It's a 2 RBI single for Highland Park and Max Salim, and they go up 5-2. To Beavers, top nine.
Batting now, number 34, Alex Slade.
Now up is Alex Salim. 2 for 4, couple of singles. That one catches the zone, 0-1. Max Salim on first. They get those two insurance runs here in the top of the ninth. This one chopped foul. No balls, two strikes to Alex Salim. So far this inning, a single, a walk, a sacrifice bunt, a 2 RBI single. O2 misses low and away, low and in, excuse me, and it's 1-2. Another foul ball.
Nice hit, Alex.
Count is 1-2 on Alex Salim. Runner off for second. Pitches up high, throw down not in time. Max Saleem takes second base. Takes away the ground ball double play. Fastball upstairs, counts run full. Matt Nelson on deck. He's been on base three times, a single and a couple of walks. Three balls, two strikes. Downstairs. Second walk this inning to go along with two hits issued out by Harrison Blum. And we're going to have a mound visit, see if they make a change or not. Tough inning so far for Harrison Blum. Looks like they'll stick with Blum. Hope he can induce a ground ball double play here. Mentioned Nelson has walked twice and singled so far in this one.
Batting now with one away, number 18, Matt Nelson.
Only time Nelson didn't get on base when he grounded into a 6-4-3 double play back in the fifth inning. Big spot here for him, two on, one out, top nine, already two in for the Beavers this inning. Time called at the plate before the pitch. They're trying to get the music turned off. Right side base hit. They're going to send around Max Saleem. Throw comes in. Oh, and it is in plenty of time. Saleem trying to get back to third. And now they've got the runner caught in a rundown. They'll tag Max Saleem out for out number two. It is a single for Nelson. Alex Saleem moves up to third. Nelson gets the single, advances to second once the rundown ensued. So it is a single for Nelson, gets to second base. Two on, two out.
Batting now number 17, Andy Devine.
So Blum gets an out even after giving up a hit there, which any way you can get it right now for the Mudcats, they're just trying to crawl into the bottom of the ninth. Hoping to keep this at a 5-2 deficit. Devine takes strike one inside corner. He's 0 for 4 with a couple of punch outs. Runners on second and third with two outs, top nine. This one to third. Diamond across the way, 5-3. Those insurance runs are big ones, though, this inning. Two runs on three hits, no errors. Two left on base. Bottom nine, Mudcats need three to stick around. Or for the win, they trail 5-2 here on PrepSpotlight.tv. We'll send you in the break, showing you highlights from some of the earlier games here from the state tournament.
This one into left field. Branstad looks up. Walk off. In the bottom of the 15th.
Here he comes. Swung on and hit a long way to left field. Wallert going back on it, and it is gone. Solo home run for Ben Suits, and he got the number one and put the whistle on it. And it's 1-0. All three runs and have four hits so far. And has a long drive to left field. Bulo going back, and he can't make the play at the fence. Hiram checked out Amundsen around third, and the throw is cut off at the plate, and it's a
trap. This one
fair down the third baseline. Coming in to score is Hoffman. Poppets will be waved around. He'll score. Sliding in left is Rowe. He blew out a tire but got it back in. Three outs to go. It looks like it's going to be Corey Ryder, the starting first baseman, tabbed with getting the final three outs in this one. And it will be Corey Ryder. Went 0 for 4 at the dish. Walk, did score a run in the ninth, as courtesy runner did. Now he needs the last three outs. 7, 8, 9 are due up for the Mudcats. They trail 5-2. Blaze Fairbanks will get it going. He's got an RBI single, 1 for 3. Last chance for the Mudcats. Two big insurance runs added to the board at the top of the ninth. Strike one there from Ryder. Works quickly. Chopper. Over the right side, stretching out. Alex Salim throws to first in time. What a play. 4-3 for out number one. One up, one down. Looks like we're going to have a pinch hitter for Tyler Fliss.
Number four, Benji Hurt.
Benji Hurth is the pinch hitter, takes strike one. Ryder kind of delivers almost from the ear, doesn't really wind or cock his arm all the way back, it doesn't look like. Still brings the heat. That one misses down low, and it's 2-1. Benji Hurth, the pinch hitter. One out, bottom nine. Slashed foul out of play. 1-2. Check that, 2-2. Oh, yeah. Breaking ball. Buckled the knees of Benji Hurth for out number two. Highland Park Beavers one out away.
Batting now number 14, David Diamond.
David Diamond will bat. He's 0 for 2. One out to get here for Ryder. Swing and a miss, strike one. And he is working fast. That one skips low, 1-1. Ryder working quickly, efficiently, effectively. Diamond, the last hope here for the Mudcats. A wave and a miss, strike two. Minneapolis down to their last strike. Ryder, wind and delivers. Diamond fights it off.
Come on, Corey,
1 more. Ryder's 1-2. Chopped, third base side, Devine. Fair ball. Oh my goodness. Just dribbled on the chalk line all the way down. Two out single for Diamond. Keeps it alive for the Mudcats. Back to the top of the order with James Wolfel, who already hit a home run back in the third inning. So the Mudcats have a chance here, 1 on, 2 outs.
Stepping to the plate now, number 5, James Wolfel.
Diamond not being held on the bag at first. Strike one right down Main Street. Riders 0-1. Popped up. Shallow right field. Alex Salim, the second baseman, makes the catch. Ball game over. Highland Park Beavers advance. They beat the Minneapolis Mudcats 5-2. It was a back and forth affair, close throughout. 5-2 is the final score. So you can stamp it in. Next Saturday, the Highland Park Beavers will take on the St. Anthony Hogs in a quarterfinal matchup. 5-2 the final score here. We've got two more games coming up on Prep Spotlight TV. Next one will be in about 40 minutes. But if the Highland Park Beavers advance to the quarterfinals to take out the Minneapolis Mudcats 5-2 as we sign off from this game. We'll have the next one coming up between St. Louis Park Stockman's Irish, St. Paul Capitals, Lions Pub Warriors also to come later on tonight. Signing off for game two of the day, Highland Park Beavers 5, Minneapolis Mudcats 2. Final score here on Prep Spotlight TV.
Amateur baseball is one of Minnesota's great sporting traditions. The state tournament brings together hundreds of communities in late summer at great ballparks all around the state. Coverage of every game can be found on PrepSpotlight.tv. PrepSpotlight.tv's coverage of today's state tournament game is made possible by the Minnesota Baseball Association. And also with help from the Minnesota Twins. Celebrate town ball with the Twins on September 11th. Visit twinsbaseball.com/townball for details. Now let's get to the ballpark.